With this video, I want to introduce the automated test execution with the Tristronic tool test guide. To understand this video, you should have basic knowledge about the Tristronic tool ECU-TEST and the test guide report management. Let's assume that we have multiple test resources. These can be real hardware-in-the-loop test benches or software-in-the-loop nodes, for example running in a cloud cluster. What we want now is to fully automate the execution of our tests such that the tests run in the correct order at the correct test resources. With this, we could optimize our test resource utilization to save valuable time at the test resources and get quicker results. We also want to have the flexibility to scale our test infrastructure and parallelize the test executions on different resources. So, how does this work with Tristronic tools? As you should know, we can use ECU-TEST to implement and execute tests. And we can use test.guide, for example, to schedule test executions, to manage test results, and to supervise our test resources. The idea is now to plan our tests with test.guide, provide the correct sources via ECU-TEST, and distribute the tests via test guide to the test resources. The actual execution is controlled via a tool installed at a test resource, the test guide resource adapter. This resource adapter instruments ECU-TEST to locally execute the tests on the test resources. The resource adapter also sends the test results via ECU-TEST back to test guide to be analyzed there. There are two things we need to describe for our test executions. What do we want to execute, and where do we want to execute it? What we want to execute is a test source and can include test cases, the system under test, and other test dependencies. This source could be, for example, an ECU-TEST workspace. It can exist on a local drive or network drive, as an artifact uploaded to the test guide artifact management, or versioned in a source code management system, such as Git or Subversion. Where we want to execute are our test resources, which can be hardware-in-the-loop test benches or software-in-the-loop nodes, no matter if Windows or Linux. These test resources have to be connected to TestGuide via the TestGuide resource adapter. We now need some type of description for our test execution, and this is a test execution task. So, the test execution task is basically a JSON file which describes what should be executed and where it should be executed. A test execution task also always has a name and a priority between nothing and 100. I now want to give an overview about the basic workflow of the automated test execution with TestGuide. On the one hand, we have our test resources with resource adapters, which are connected to TestGuide and send their states and configurations to the TestGuide test infrastructure. On the other hand, we have our test sources as artifacts in the TestGuide artifact management, or located on a local or network drive, or in an SCM repository. We now can upload test execution tasks to the test guide test execution. The execution task has requirements to the test resources. These requirements describe in an abstract way what the test resource needs to fulfill to be able to execute the test execution task. So, based on the requirements, an uploaded execution task first computes its matching test resources based on the information of the test guide test infrastructure. If a test resource is free, it fetches the execution task with the highest priority. It downloads the test source to the test resource and then executes the test via ECU-TEST. When the test was executed completely, the execution task's state is updated in the test guide test execution, and the test result is uploaded to the test guide test report management. I now want to demonstrate this basic workflow in test guide. First, I want to show you my test resources, I before configured some resource adapters as workers for my test execution. You can look at their configurations in test guide via the test resource details. All information you see here are provided by the test guide resource adapter. You can specify multiple plugins in the resource adapter to describe all information you want to see here. I uploaded some self-defined test resource configurations via the resource adapter configuration plugin. For example, one with the category electrical system, the label battery, and the ID of the battery as a value. I also activated the resource adapter execution plugin to use the resource adapter for the automated test execution. I also already uploaded my test source to the test guide artifact management as a compressed ECU-TEST workspace. You can see all uploaded artifacts in the artifact overview. This is the ECU-TEST workspace I uploaded as my test source. So my test source is basically just an artifact with the ID mydepot-2536. You can see the details of a test execution task in the execution tasks details page. As I already told, an execution task has always a user-defined name. In this example, my first execution task, and a priority between nothing and 100, in this example 42. It specifies that the test source is our uploaded artifact with the ID mydepot-2536. It also has requirements to the test resources. These are always triples of category, label, and value. In this example, we want the execution task to be executed at a test resource which has a category electrical system, a label battery, and a value that ends with underscore Montevideo. As you can see here, you can also use wildcards in the execution task's requirements. Remember, you find the same triples as configurations in the test resources details. I now want to upload a new test execution task to test guide. I choose the JSON file which describes the execution task I want to upload. The execution task now appears in the overview and is immediately matched by two test resources, because both fulfill the requirements of the execution task. So it switches to the task state waiting, and after a free test resource fetched the execution task, it switches to the task state running. We can see now that on my local PC, which is also my test resource in this demo, ECU-TEST opens and executes the specified tests. We can filter all test execution tasks at the top of the execution tasks overview. We can also rerun an execution task or do some other actions. The execution task is now finished and the test results were uploaded to the test guide report management. You can easily switch to a filter of all test results, which were created by this execution task. This was a small introduction into the automated test execution via test guide. I hope you enjoyed the video.